A lot of parents want their children to get into the best public school. But what happens when you live outside the district? How do schools decide which kids get a geographic exception? Gina Mangieri is always investigating and discovered it's not that easy to find out.
The state's public school geographic exception process appears to be used in many cases for talent-based relocations. It's something the department does not have the ability to track centrally, and schools aren't selecting kids through any standard process.
How well can you pass? Catch? Run? Even play? At some Hawaii public schools, that could make or break whether you get a coveted geographic exception or whether you get denied.
It seems a little too coincidental, I guess.
That's how parents reacted when Always Investigating showed them numbers it took us about 6 months to gather from the Department of Education. That's because the DOE does not keep a database of who is GE'd into what school and why. Instead, each campus has to be asked one by one. Our public record request, filed back in April, got answers from a handful of big high schools known for football, band, or both. Here's what we found. Schools like Moanalua and Kaiser had dozens of kids from outside the neighborhood who switched schools and played football. Band was even higher, more than 70 a year, 80 a year GE'd musicians at Moanalua High. Taken together with football, Moanalua, as an example, had the majority of the GE kids appearing to have come ready to play.
When you hear those numbers and how much end up went on a certain team or in a certain band, what do you think?
Well, yeah, it seems a little skewed. I mean, when you think about it, it's like, how does that happen? And what is the process for that happening?
How does that happen when the geographic exception form does not list athletics or extracurriculars as a reason to switch?
How is preference supposed to be determined among the applying families, or is it supposed to be random?
Well, GEs, the purpose of GEs is to provide an opportunity for kids to have access to an academic program. But every school handles it very differently, and usually it's, sometimes it's a lottery system and it's random.
But how random is it? We tried to ask Moanalua. None of our many phone and even in-person requests were responded to. Same at Kaiser. So we asked another school principal to explain.
Where are the potential pitfalls in the process as it currently is?
Well, so there are guidelines, but they're interpreted, I believe, differently at different schools.
When you see certain schools with high numbers in something that's not academic, football or band, are there red flags there that should be watched?
So if there's a spike in numbers for a particular program, it's probably because they're doing a very good job.
Good job, no doubt. These schools are highly regarded, and that's why so many parents hope their kids will get drawn in the random process. And many parents say the process is fine how it is now.
A lot of the GE kids do end up playing the sports or playing in the band. Do you think that that's right, or should it be more random?
I think that because Moanalua offers programs like the orchestra that a lot of high schools don't, it gives kids an opportunity to really study music that they couldn't otherwise in their area. So I don't think it should be random. I think that this is a special school and people should want to be here.
But what about the campuses that have more GEs out than in? Fewer students means less cash for the school.
What should be done about this system?
Well, I do believe that the department ought to engage in some dialogue about what can be done to make the system more equitable so that schools aren't massively losing amounts of kids.
Is there anything being done in your department to check who is getting geographic exemptions and why?
No, we currently do not have a database on tracking geographic exceptions. So that technology isn't available to us at this time.
Do you think that needs to change?
It's definitely something that we want to consider changing.
That lack of a database is why we had such a hard time getting information from schools. Mililani, Pearl City, Lelehua, for example, left out a lot of information in our public records request simply because they say they don't track it. We'll follow up to see if the DOE makes any changes to the exception selection process to make it more open. Gina Mangieri, KHON 2 News.